Welcome to Beware the Scare. My name is Tyler Style, and today we're going to be starting a brand new series called 10 Minute Movies, where I go through a whole movie's plot in roughly 10 minutes, give or take a couple. It's basically like how Scariest Moments used to be, but now that series is going to be all about the scariest moments, where this one is going to be about the whole plot. Today we'll be looking into Saw, which was released in 2004 and created by James Wan and Lee Whannell. James Wan directed the movie while Lee Whannell starred in it, following Adam and Lawrence, who are trapped in a bathroom by a man they call Jigsaw, and they must do whatever it takes to survive. This is the first movie in an 8-movie series that we're going to be covering for the next 2 months. Now let's get into it. The movie starts off with a man sleeping in a bathtub as we follow an object floating around in the water. The man wakes up and pulls the plug on the bath, making the water go down. Hopefully that object has some importance in the— oh, there it goes. He jumps out of the bathtub and realizes that he is chained to a pipe. He hears another person in the room and the lights come on. Now that we can actually see these people, let's introduce them. Bathtub Boy is named Adam, and he is played by Lee Whannell, who created this movie with the director James Wan. He also directed a movie that came out this year called The Invisible Man. I made a video all about The Invisible Man, and there's actually a reference to Saw in it, so go check out that video to see the reference. The other man in the room is Lawrence Gordon, who's played by Cary Elwes. You might recognize him as the mayor in season 3 of Stranger Things. As they look around the room, they notice that they aren't the only ones in there, as they see a man who killed himself in the middle of the bathroom. Lawrence tries to get some information about Adam, but he doesn't cooperate.
What's your name?
My name is very fucking confused. What's your name?
Lawrence realizes that whoever captured them did it for a reason, because they could have already killed them. He looks around the disgusting room and notices a brand new clock, meaning that they want them to know the time. Adam finds a tape in his back pocket, and Lawrence finds a tape, a key, and a bullet in his back pocket. They see the tape recorder in the dead man's hand, and after some attempts to retrieve it, Adam finally gets it. Adam listens to his tape first, which basically just says that this could be the room that he dies in. Lawrence throws Adam his tape, and it says that Lawrence must kill Adam by 6 p.m. or else his wife and daughter will be killed. And then the tape has a cryptic message.
Just remember, X marks the spot for the treasure.
Lawrence demands the tape recorder for Adam and reverses it, just to stop it at the perfect time. I'm calling bullshit. He also hears someone whisper at the end of the tape, and the person says, "Follow your heart." They look around the room and see a toilet with a heart on it. Adam reaches his hand into the disgusting toilet, and Lawrence asks if he found anything.
Anything? No solids.
Adam then opens up the back of the toilet and finds a couple hacksaws. They try to break through their chains with it, but the chains are too strong. Lawrence thinks he figured out who could be doing this to them. He tells the story about a serial killer who the press calls Jigsaw because of the puzzle pieces he cuts out of his victims. There's a flashback to a previous crime that shows Paul, who had to get through a maze of razor wire within 2 hours or else he will be locked in the room forever. The reason why Paul had to do this was because he slit his wrist with a razor blade. Paul didn't make it out, obviously. They show a different crime with Mark, who faked an illness to get out of work. So Jigsaw put him to the test, where he had to walk around a room with a candle and get the combination for a safe to get the antidote for a poison in his body. Only problem was that the floor had shattered glass on it and he was covered in a flammable substance. They found a penlight at the crime scene that belonged to Lawrence Gordon. The flashback continues with Lawrence giving some details about a patient when a nurse named Zepp walked in and told him that the patient's name is John. Lawrence gets called to his office, where he is confronted by Detective Tapp and Detective Singh. Detective Tapp is actually played by Danny Glover. Lawrence's alibi checks out, and they bring in the only survivor from a Jigsaw case named Amanda Young. Amanda had a device on her head that worked like a reverse bear trap. Amanda needed to stab her dead cellmate on the other side of the room and retrieve the key from inside his body within 60 seconds. Only issue is that he wasn't actually dead, just injected with an opioid overdose, meaning he couldn't move, but he was awake the entire time. Adam thinks that Lawrence is the one who kidnapped him, and he picks up a piece of a mirror he broke when he threw something at it earlier in the film. He notices that it's a two-way mirror and breaks the rest of the mirror to see a camera behind it. We then get to see someone watching them on a monitor.
I can see you.
No shit. Adam talks about how they also have Lawrence's family, and we see a flashback from the last time he saw his wife, Allison, and his daughter, Diana. Diana gets scared because she thinks someone is in her closet, so she gets up and wakes up her mom. Allison comes to Lawrence, who is working on his computer, and he says he will handle it in a few. He puts Diana to bed and goes to the living room and argues with Allison. We go back to the bathroom and Lawrence throws Adam his wallet to show pictures of his family, and Adam finds a picture of them captured but hides it without telling Lawrence. After Lawrence leaves the house, we see that Diana was right to be scared when she hears the man in the closet talking. He jumps out and ties up Allison and Diana. He listens to Diana's heart rate as he points a gun to her mom's head. We then see that Detective Tapp is actually watching the person who kidnapped Lawrence's family from a telescope. We go to another flashback where Detective Tapp is watching one of the old Jigsaw tapes. He realizes that there was a fire alarm that went off during the recording, and they used that in addition with a gang symbol to figure out where the warehouse is. They break into the warehouse to find Jigsaw's lair. They find Billy the Puppet and a ghost. Just kidding, it's just a man under a sheet. They pull the sheet off, but then hear Jigsaw coming back, so they put the sheet back on and hide. Jigsaw walks into the room and they reveal themselves, telling him he's under arrest. Jigsaw starts the trap that the man is in, and Detective Singh tries to stop it, and Tapp puts Jigsaw on his knees. Singh starts shooting the machine to try to make it stop, and while Tapp is distracted, Jigsaw pulls out a blade and slits Tapp's throat. Jigsaw runs away and Singh follows him. Singh shoots Jigsaw while down a hallway, and when walking up to him, trips a wire that ends Singh's life via shotguns. Jigsaw gets back up and walks away right before Tapp comes to see that Singh is dead. We go back to present day where we see that the man who kidnapped everyone is Zepp from the hospital. Lawrence turns the lights off to find the X marks the spot. He breaks through the wall to find a box. He opens the box and it has a cigarette, a note that the cigarette is harmless but he can kill Adam with it, and a phone that only allows incoming calls. We get to see how Lawrence was captured and it shows him walking to his car. He hears a camera take a photo but disregards it. He tries to make a phone call on the telephone in the garage but it isn't working. We watch as a man in a pig mask attacks Lawrence. Adam shows Lawrence the photo that he hid earlier, and this makes Lawrence get a little angry. He remembers that the tape said that there's poison in the dead man's blood, so he takes a cigarette and puts one of the ends into the blood, making it poisonous. He makes sure the camera sees him and turns out the lights. He whispers to Adam to play along with this, but we don't know what that means yet. They turn the light back on and Lawrence gives Adam a cigarette that wasn't dipped in the poison. Adam then smokes it and gives the worst performance of his life. Adam acts like he's dead, but gets electrocuted to prove that he's not. That shock must have really helped Adam because he remembers how he got captured. We go to a flashback where he goes into his apartment. Adam's a photographer and we see him putting up a picture of Lawrence in his darkroom. Adam wakes up to a noise and walks around his house using a camera's flash to get some light. He finds Billy the Puppet and starts beating the puppet with a bat. He continues his search and the man in the pig mask attacks Adam after Adam finds him in the closet. There's only 23 minutes until it's 6 and the phone starts to ring. Lawrence picks up and it's his daughter on the other line. His daughter is crying and tells him that the man who captured them has a gun. The man takes the phone and gives it to Allison. Allison tells Lawrence that Adam knows exactly who he is and he is lying about not knowing him. Lawrence confronts Adam and Adam confesses that he was the person who took Lawrence's picture in the parking garage. He also watched Lawrence go into the hotel room with his secretary, and we see that when Lawrence got into the room, he was hesitant to do anything with her. The hotel phone rings and when the secretary picks it up, she gives it to Lawrence saying it's for him.
Hello? I know what you're doing, Doctor.
Adam tells Lawrence that he got paid by Detective Tapp to follow him. The two argue and Adam says that Lawrence is just mad that he caught him cheating on his wife. Lawrence denies that he cheated and Adam says that he shouldn't care what he thinks.
What do you care what I think anyway? I don't give a crap if you covered yourself in peanut butter and had a 15-hooker gangbang.
Allison and Diana get free from their restraints, but stay seated where they are. Adam notices that the clock hits 6, and that means Zepp is gonna go kill Diana and Allison. Zepp goes into the room and has Allison call Lawrence to tell him that he failed. While doing so, she starts fighting with Zepp and gets the gun. After not shooting him for some reason, she gets distracted by Diana and Zepp attacks her. When fighting over the gun, some shots are fired and Lawrence thinks that Zepp killed his family. Tapp breaks into the house and fights Zepp as Allison and Diana run away. Zepp gets away and announces that he is gonna go kill Lawrence. Lawrence gets shocked the same way Adam did, and we go to a car chase between Zepp and Tap. This is where you can really see the small budget for this movie. These cars don't even look like they're moving. Lawrence wakes up after being shocked, and after having a mental breakdown decides that he has to cut off his own foot to escape. As Lawrence is cutting off his own foot, Zepp and Tap are in the building, and Tap catches up to Zepp. Zepp ends up winning the fight and kills Tap. With Lawrence being free now, he crawls over to the gun and loads it with the bullet he got earlier. He shoots Adam and Zepp comes in saying that it's too late and that Lawrence must die. It turns out that Adam isn't dead and he attacks Zepp. He ends up taking the back lid of the toilet and beats him with it until he is more than dead. Lawrence says that he has to leave because he is bleeding out and that he will come back for Adam. Adam begs him not to leave, but Lawrence has to or else he'll die. Lawrence leaves and Adam searches Zepp's pockets. He finds a tape and we learn that Zepp was forced to do this and he wasn't the Jigsaw killer. As we learn this, the dead man in the middle of the room stands up and he is not only Jigsaw, but he is also the man who Zepp said was named John earlier in the film. John tells Adam that he can escape from the key in the bathtub we saw earlier, but if you remember correctly, that key went down the toilet. Adam realizes this and grabs the gun, attempting to kill him, but John shocks him and turns out the lights, ending the movie with the now iconic line.
Game over.
Saw was released in 2004 and spawned 7 sequels, with an 8th that was already supposed to come out but got delayed because of COVID. Like I said earlier, we're going to be covering all the Saw movies over the next 2 months. This movie, however, is very different from the other films because the other films focus more on the traps. If you haven't seen Saw yet, go watch it. This video is pretty short compared to the actual runtime of the movie, and there's a lot you missed, but you get the gist. My name is Tyler Style, and this has been Beware the Scare. Thank you guys for watching my video on the original Saw movie. Comment down below what your favorite scene was. I'm so glad to be making videos again, and this is actually going to be my full-time job for the next while. We're gonna have at least 2 horror videos every week, so if that sounds interesting to you, make sure to subscribe. I hope you guys have an amazing day, and I'll catch you guys later.